Amen. I want to share message. The time is drawing near for you, young man. If you please have your Bibles, please turn with me to Romans chapter 13, verses 9 through 14. Romans chapter 13, verses 9 through 14. Dealing with time. Amen. We got to learn how to take advantage of time. Amen. God giving us time. We got to learn how to take advantage of it. Many people have passed away, amen, and got killed, amen, because they didn't take advantage of time. Amen. We got to learn to take advantage of time because time is drawing near. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 13, verses 9 through 14, it says, "For this, thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness." It said, "Thou shalt not covet, and if there be any other commandment, it is briefly comprehended in this end, namely, that thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself." The Bible said that love worketh no ill to his neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. And that knowing the time that now is, it is high time to wake up out of sleep. Amen. Young man, it's time to wake up out of sleep. Amen. We can't, many people fall asleep in the church, but it's time to wake up. Amen. The Lord said it's time to wake up out of sleep. It says now our salvation near when we have, it say our top, now is our salvation near when we believe. 12 say the night is far spent and the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the work of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. It said, let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting or in drunkenness, not in chambering or wantonness, not in strife and envy. It say, but put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. Amen. Time is drawing near. Amen. We don't have time to make provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. Amen. Because many young men and many people that living in this day of time, amen, they died day by day. Amen. And Jesus is soon to return. And time is drawing near because they fail to take advantage of time. Amen. We got to take advantage of time because time is drawing near. We don't want time to run out on us. Amen. A lot of people's in the grave because they didn't take advantage of time. Each day that we get, each day that God wake you up, amen, you need to take advantage of it. You need to put in your mind, say, I'm going to keep all the commandments of God. Amen. I'm going to follow everything that the Lord have commanded me to do. Amen. It's not time, like Pastor John was saying, it's not time to go back and backslide. Amen. Because once you backslide, you might not come back. Amen. It's many people that backslid and then come back to the Lord. Amen. So when you get saved, you need to stand strong no matter what temptation come your way. And if you do backslide, you need to repent quickly. Jesus said, repent quickly unless I come and remove your candlestick. Amen. We don't have time to be out here playing games with the devil. Amen. Because when devil come, amen, that's it. That's why we got to take advantage of time. Time is drawing near. It's time to take advantage of time. Amen. You need to stay saved while you're still in your young state. Amen. The best time to get saved is while you was young. You young, you need to serve God fully. Amen. You need to sit on the Pastor Jones, take that word in. Not only take it in, but you need to hide it in your heart. So when the devil come, amen, you got something to fight the devil with. Amen. Don't just hear the word and let it go in one ear out the other, but take advantage of it. Amen. Because time is drawing near. And I got one more scripture, Ezekiel chapter 7. Chapter 7, verse 7 through 12. Amen. Time is drawing near. We got to take advantage of time. We got to take advantage of time. Amen. Because Jesus is coming back. We got to take advantage of time. Young man, take advantage of time. Don't let nobody fill your mind up with deceivingness. Amen. Don't let the enemy come. Amen. Because the Bible said that the devil come to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Amen. He's seeking to take out young men. Everybody that's dying, it ain't the old people that's dying. It's the young men. Amen, for 20 on down, even in their 20s, some in their 30s, they dying. Amen, because they fail to take advantage of time. God giving us time right now. He said time is near, time is drawing near. Amen, we don't have time to be playing games. We don't have time to go into the world and to be playing with sin. Amen, because the devil trying to kill you. Amen, hell is real. Hell is a real place. Amen, I don't want to live all this time. Amen. And live out here and live in the world. Amen. Because God is calling us to sanctification. Amen. As young men, you need to be holy. Amen. Y'all is the future. Amen. When Jesus comes, amen, you need to be fine doing what God called us to do. Amen. Ezekiel chapter 7, verses 7 through 12. The Bible says, the morning is come unto thee, O thou that dwellest in the land. It says the time is come. The day of trouble is near. God said the day of trouble is near and the time have come. And the Bible said, and not the sounding again of the mountains. He said, now will I shortly pour out my fury upon thee and accomplish my anger upon thee. He said, and I will judge thee according to thy ways and will recompense thee for all thy abominations. Verse 9 says, and my eyes shall not spare, neither shall I have pity. I will recompense, which means to repay thee according to thy ways and thy abomination that are in the midst of thee, and that ye shall know that I am the Lord that smiteth. Behold, the day, behold, it is come. The morning is gone forth. The rod have blossomed. Pride have budded. Violence is risen up in a rod of wickedness. None of them shall remain, nor of the multitudes, nor any theirs, nor shall there be any dwelling for them. And verse 12 says, the time is come. The day draweth near. Let not the buyer rejoice, nor the seller mourn, for wrath is upon all the multitude thereof. God said, the time is come. Amen. The time is now. Amen. To be a man. Amen. You're a young man. You need to be a man. Amen. You don't have time to be playing games with the enemy because the devil will kill you. The devil is not your friend. The Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil. The devil is your adversary. Adversary be your enemy. The devil is your enemy. He is not your friend. Amen. So you don't have time to be out here trying to play games with the devil. You don't have time to sell drugs. You don't have time to be chasing women. Amen. Because the devil is trying to kill you. God said the time is drawing now. Now is the time to get it right with God. Amen. You don't have tomorrow. Now is the day. God said the day when you hear his voice. He said, harden not your heart. Amen. If you got the Holy Ghost, you need to stand strong. You need to keep the Holy Ghost. That's the most precious thing that God gave you is the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is like a most precious stone. It's like a jewel. Amen. It's more precious than a diamond. Amen. You know diamonds is expensive. But when you get the Holy Ghost, you need to hold on to it. Amen. God, when you get the Holy Ghost is so precious, man. I'm telling you. Amen. Before I got saved, I used to do things of the enemy. Amen. I used to curse. I used to do this. I used to do that. Brother Miller can testify to the same thing. I used to chase women. Amen. I hung with killers. I hung with guys that kidnap people. Amen. But when I got filled with the Holy Ghost, amen, I was not the same. Amen. I was a changed man. Amen. God said you should receive power after that the Holy Ghost have come upon you. Amen. When you say power, amen, that means you enabled to do what God called you to do. You got all the power of the devil, amen. The devil should not be having victory in your life. But God said, I give you power and all the power over the enemy. When Jesus gave you power, he said, all the power, A-L-L, all the power. Not some power, so amen. All the excuses been nailed to the cross. Amen. When Jesus was crucified, he died for your sins, he died for my sins. Amen. Jesus ain't died in vain. Amen. The Bible says he was wounded for your transgression. He was bruised by my iniquities. And the chastisement of our peace was upon him. Amen. Everything that Jesus bowed, he bowed everything on the cross. Amen. So we don't have time to be out here playing because time is drawing near. Amen. Time is drawing near. Amen. You need to respect your parents. You need to obey your father. You need to obey your mother. Amen. Every time you disobey your mother and father, the Bible says you cut your days short. If your mother or your father tell you to do something, you don't need to smack your lips or do nothing. You need to do what they told you to do. Amen. Because you can find yourself getting angry. And the Bible said that anger lies in the bosom of fools. Amen. The longer you hold that anger in you, the longer the foolish you become. Amen. And that make you prone to do things that's not godly. That make you prone to do things that's not godlike. Amen. God said the time is drawing near. Amen. God, the judgment of God will follow you quick. Amen. If you don't repent quickly. Amen. You should be living free from sin anyway when God gave you power. Amen. Just because we old don't mean that we can't live free from sin. We old. Amen. God got us to be able to show y'all and set the path straight. He said he called the young because they are strong and the old because they know the way. Amen. He called old man because they got more wisdom than you. Amen. You need to cling to somebody like me, Pastor Jones, or Brother Middleton who'd have been there and done that. Amen. We'd have been there. Amen. We'd have held hands with the devil. Amen. But God giving you young men an opportunity. Amen. He saved y'all at a young age. Amen. So y'all won't have to go through what we went through. Amen. We went through this. We went through water. We went through the fire. Amen. But thank God, God had his hand on us. Amen. Sometimes everybody ain't got the same grace. Everybody ain't got the same mercy. Amen. We can play with God's mercy and grace so long and it ain't gonna run out. Amen. But God, even Paul. Amen. Paul prayed to God. He had a thorn in his flesh. Paul said, that was given to me, a thorn in my flesh for the messenger of Satan to buffet me. They say he prayed to God and asked him thrice, which means three times to take it away. And God said, my grace is sufficient for you.
And in your weakness, my strength is made perfect. Amen. No matter what you're going through, no matter what type of temptation you young man is facing, amen, God said my strength is sufficient for you. Amen. Whatever you're going through, God is able to give you strength to make it through. Amen. God is able to bring you out of any situation, no matter what it is. And if you make a mistake and get in some mess, God will bring you out of it. The Bible said, with every temptation, God make a way for you to escape. Amen. I don't care what you mean, God make a way for escape. Amen. Sin is a choice. Amen. You got to make a choice. Do I want to do this or do that? The enemy will present it to you. He'll dress it up, make it look like a birthday cake. But how many of you know God, like he told Adam and Eve? Amen. He set the tree of good and evil. He told them, you can eat from the tree of good, but don't eat from this tree, which is the evil tree. Yeah. Amen. Then the devil came and he deceived Eve. Yeah. Amen. He said, no, you can eat it, because when you eat it, your eyes will become open. And then you go know good from evil, and you will be like God. Amen. He did tell the truth to a certain extent, but it was still a lie. Amen. How many of you know that a half of the truth is still a lie? Amen. He said that if you eat it, your eyes will become open. You're going to be as God. But they didn't know that they were going to die spiritually. Amen. So don't let the devil deceive you with the things of this world. Amen. Somebody come offer you an opportunity to be a millionaire, get rich, quit scheme. Say, go on, sell this, man. All you got to do it one time. But that's the trick of the enemy, because once you do it one time, you get addicted. Amen. And that's a spirit that become a stronghold. How many of you know that the Bible said that the yoke should be destroyed because of the anointing? Amen. When you got filled with the Holy Ghost, God destroyed the yoke that was on your life. Everything that the devil tried to have you bound by, God destroyed that. He got rid of it. Amen. He gave you power. And we got to live right in this day and time, because the time is drawing near. Amen. Jesus is coming soon. Amen. Don't let nobody put in your mind that Jesus ain't coming. When Jesus said, I'm coming, he's coming. If he don't come tomorrow, he's still coming. If he don't come next week, he's still coming. Amen. He's still coming. Amen. You don't know when he comes. No, Bible said, no man know the time nor the day when Jesus comes. Amen. No, God, don't let the devil make a fool of you. Amen. He's making me so mad, and I'm mad at the devil right now. Amen. Because he's taking so many of our young men, our young women. Amen. They die without Jesus. I preached in my message last Sunday. I said, what makes me sad is to see somebody die without Jesus. Amen. When I see somebody die without Jesus, it hurts me to my heart. It's not the point that they die, because we all got to die, but because they die without Jesus. Amen. Don't die without Jesus. Keep the Holy Ghost. Hang on to it, because time is drawing near. Amen. You don't want Jesus to come and find you, and you ain't got his spirit up in you. But the Bible said, well, man had not the spirit of Christ, he is none of his. If you ain't got the Holy Ghost, you is none of his. But when you get the Spirit of God, you belong to God. The Bible said, whatever you ask, Jesus will give it to you. Amen. If it's according to his will. If it's according to his will. Amen. I'm reminded by the story of Solomon. Solomon prayed and asked God for wisdom. He said, since you ain't asked for riches of this, he gave him wisdom. Then he's still blessed to be rich. He's still blessed to be rich, but he didn't know how to handle that. He was a king, a man in authority, and he had all that. Everybody ain't going to be rich. Amen. The Bible said, don't labor to be rich. Amen. Ain't no sin to be rich, but don't labor to be rich. Amen. Don't come out here trying to rap and trying to get rich. That ain't nothing but a trick of the enemy. When you go try to sign a rubber, then you sign a contract, you're selling your soul to the devil. You're selling your soul to the devil. Don't let nobody deceive you, because the devil is a lie. The devil is a lie. Amen. You ought to get in your mind, you ought to get mad. When you get mad at the devil, amen, you are anything that's not like God, amen, you rebuke. You shun everything. You shun every vain babbling. You shun every vain thing that somebody come try to speak to you to deceive you. Amen. The devil will use people. The devil will use people. And once y'all get in high school, the devil will use little females to try to come to y'all. Amen. To try to present her body to you, which is of the devil. But you got to be strong enough. Amen. And put in your mind that time is drawing near. I love God more than I love my flesh. Amen. You got to love God more than you love your flesh. Amen. Some stuff that your flesh want to do, you got to say no. You got to say no and get in your concept and say, I love God. Amen. You got to get a relationship with God that you love him so much. Just think about, just sit down one day and ask yourself, say, man, look what Jesus did for me. He done all this. He went through all this. They spit on him for me. Amen. They whipped him all night long. Amen. They whipped him. Amen. They put a crown of 72 thorns on his head. They pierced him in the side. Amen. They beat Jesus. They beat Jesus for you and me. Amen. So we can have free. The Bible said, who the Son set free, they is free indeed. Amen. Once the Lord set you free, do not go back on God. Amen. Because there's spirits out there. There's demons out here that's waiting to get to enter your body. Because once you get out the will of God, a demon can enter your body. Amen. So don't allow nobody to deceive you, young man, because the time is drawing near. We're in the last days. We're living in the last days, and y'all the future. God will raise up y'all. Some of y'all will be prophets. Some of y'all will be pastors. Amen. Y'all gonna be on fire for God. But y'all gotta stand strong in this day and time. Amen. Just take one day at a time. Don't worry about the future. Amen. Just live for the day. Live the day like it's your last day, because you don't know when your last day is. And you don't know when Jesus is coming back. In Jesus' name.